Chi-Town Constrictors. Going all the way back to August, I started a series of videos to follow the progression of one of my pairings that I wanted to do to show you guys from start all the way to finish what things look like and how things should operate. Today I'm finally coming at you with the video showing the end result. Back in August, I started ultrasounding one of my favorite females, a VPI T-positive Sun Glow Harlequin. She wasn't anywhere near ready to breed, but I went ahead and I did a couple of things. I fed her, I did a couple of tricks that I do to provoke them to start developing follicles. I ended up eventually introducing a male, which you guys may remember was a Pastel Dream Hypo Jungle, and he bred her for several weeks, and then eventually he ran out of gas. So what I then had to do was take another male and throw him in just to keep her going, because she had already started developing her follicles, and I didn't want to run the chance that she might eventually slug out from the lack of sperm. So the second male that I put in was a VPI T-positive IMG Sun Glow Jungle. So the problem that you run into when you use two males like that is you do run the chance of having babies from both males. You can actually have a dual sired litter. Once upon a time I was known as the king of split litters because I used to do that on purpose many times, and this time it ended up happening again. Now it's very important that if you're going to use two males, you have to do it in a certain way where you're going to be able to tell which babies are going to be from which male. So this one was very easy. The female was a visual VPI Sun Glow, and one of the sires was not a VPI at all. He wasn't het, he wasn't a visual, he was nothing. So any babies that come from those two are going to be non-VPI, but they're going to be het VPI because the mom has that. The other sire that I used was a visual VPI, which basically made a visual to a visual, which means all of the babies are going to come out as VPI albinos in some way, shape, or form. So all of the babies are either going to come out as non-visuals, which are going to be from the Pastel Dream Hypo Jungle, or they're going to be visuals, which are going to be from the IMG Sun Glow Jungle. So this is a very easy way to do a split litter and know exactly which babies came from which dad. Now what ended up happening is I got a very small litter and I only got one baby that was not a visual VPI. So that means that the Pastel Dream Hypo Jungle only sired one baby out of the entire litter, but it is enough to make it a split litter. And the IMG Sun Glow Jungle got all of the rest of them and they came out really cool looking. So why don't we take a look at exactly what I got. So as you guys saw, I really got lucky. I had some really good looking babies. I've really been impressed with this line of jungle that I've been working with. They throw very high expression jungles most times, and a lot of these are no different. They came out really, really nice. A lot of these are also possible super hypos as well, or super sun glows rather, because the mom was a sun glow, so she had hypo, and the dad was also a sun glow. So a lot of these are super hypos, which I technically cannot sell them and guarantee them to be super hypo, but you can take a pretty educated guess looking at them which ones are which. Unfortunately, I know a lot of you guys have been asking what I'm going to have available from this litter, what's for sale, where I'm going to be posting them. The bad news is I'm already sold out. Anything that was going to be offered for sale was already on a waiting list and is already gone. All that I've got left is whatever I'm keeping for myself. So unfortunately, I'm already sold out, and you guys are going to have to wait for the next one. But I'm glad that this litter worked out the way that I was hoping that it would. You guys got to see it from start to finish, all the way to the end result of babies. So I hope this has been educational for you guys. As always, I encourage you guys to reach out to me. Find me on Facebook, find me on Instagram, send me messages through here on YouTube. Any questions that you guys got, I will try to answer them in one of my videos coming up. I hope that this was a learning process from start to finish. I hope I helped you guys out a little bit. Breeding season for the coming year is right around the corner. I have a lot of really cool stuff coming up. I'm excited about this year. It's going to be a big one with some really cool projects coming up. So I may do a couple more videos this year, and any questions that you guys have that I maybe didn't cover through this series of videos, I'll try to do them next time around. I got a couple more litters coming up. Stay tuned for that. Wish you guys the best. Take care.